for so many flavors in Informatica. Informatica Power Center, Informatica Power Exchange, Data Quality, Metadata Manager, and all the stuff, for current purpose, Informatica is nothing but integrating all the environments, whatever the system, source system you have. It integrates and loads into the data warehouse. It's an extracting tool from the different source system. And it integrates whatever the cloud, if it is a source system is cloud computing or SAP ERP or Oracle HRMS or Siebel or Sybase, whatever the source system, doesn't matter. We can take the data from different source system and we can store it into a database. It's a unified structure. Okay, so that users can able to understand and can able to regenerate reports based upon their requirement. Okay, so current agenda is, it's a 9 version of Informatica which I'm going to teach you. And its objective is building basic ETM mappings and creating workflows and sessions. What are the different types of tools which we have, which available in Informatica Power Center? And administration task, administration tasks, and how we can enable this, how we can create users, and how we can enable the exact repository services, what type of services we have, and troubleshooting problems and complex mappings. And these are the core basic course objective. And you can just, I can show you the advanced mapping levels, okay. Once we complete the basic Informatica ETL mappings, then I'll give you the how to do the performance tuning, okay, and how to create complex mappings based upon the requirement, and how to generate SCD type 2 mappings, okay, slowly chain dimensions. And I guess I'm just assuming that you have a little bit knowledge on data warehouse and concepts. If not, please let me know so that I can cover those topics also, so that you'll get a good idea and how to create fact tables and how to load the fact table data and how to load the dimensional table data. Okay, so basically I'm just going through a brief introduction of Informatica Power Center. And this basically is extract, transform and loading data. And we have different types of operational source systems. It might be transactional data or normalized or denormalized. Whatever the data we have, we can take data from mainframes, RDBMS, and SAP, as I already told you. And decision support, it's a data warehouse. Why we are maintaining data warehouse means it's a decision supporting system which maintains historical data. Okay, and this is the main brief structure about extract, transform, and loading. That's nothing but ETL. And for this, once you use Informatica, okay, you can do ETL or ELT. That means extract, load, then transform, so that you can get good quality of data. Okay, and so many companies which are using, which are going through ELT process. That is extract, load, then transform the data instead of doing transforming data. So to maintain the data, good quality of data. But if we have a data quality and Informatica data quality, you can maintain a data, good quality of data, 90% of accuracy of data which you can get by using the data quality that is integrated with Informatica Power Center. So nine version onwards, that is the major aspect. That means we can do the integration from the data quality and Informatica Power Center and Power Exchange. So basically 1.5 hour per day, 4 weeks training course, and version is 9.0. I'll give you the good, what is the main major differences between 8.6 and 9. Okay, and I'll give some tasks to work you, so that you can get a good idea. Once you complete the task, we'll continue the next time. If you have any doubts, please mail me or text me. So that, or else, you can contact Kapil, so that he can send the updates. Okay, and for that purpose, we can improve our learning prospects. So if you have any queries, please feel free to reach me. is it in the class or instead of in the class, be after the class, once the class is complete, please let me know so that we can work together. Okay, and I'll give the exact solution what you are looking for. Okay, if you have any other if you have any questions, please feel free to reach me. And this is a basic Informatica high level architect designing. So what type of sources we have and how to how it uses. Basically, these are the different types of sources, and this is the data warehouse. And between these two, we have Informatica, transforming and transformations using. Okay, and we can develop data marts, and which we can send it to the reports to the user directly, or data marts to Cube. Cube is a multi-dimensional database, and which is created by a reporting tool people. That means BA, business intelligence, that is Hyperion or Cognos or BOS or MicroStrategy. Those people, you know, they create some cubes, and so that they can extract the data from Cube itself. Datamart is a subset of a data warehouse, and that means if you have a huge data warehouse and you don't want to see a lot of tables, and if you would like to, we can create data marts, and we can send it to the users. Sometimes we can send data from data warehouse itself to users, okay, by sending flat files or giving access to the views, okay, instead of giving tables, because some of the security reasons which we don't give a direct table access. Okay, that's why we create some views for the particular users, and others just we can send flat files to the users. So this is a high level design for ETL, Informatica ETL, how it works and how it integrates and how to create a data warehouse. So basically, this is a brief introduction of Informatica, and we have different types of services and architecture-wise which we have. I'll show you the architecture-wise. So Power Center architecture, we have so many aspects in this. One is node and domain and report service and integration service, reporting service, repository. So what are the main things which we need to take care about is a node, a domain, a service. These are the main things which we have to take care. If you don't have a node, yes, you can't install any software. So I'll show you what is the node. So this is admin console. See, this is the node, and host name is my laptop. That means see, whatever the computer name you have, that is nothing but your node. Okay, that's what, if you don't have a node, yes, you can't install Informatica software. That is what which here it is saying. See, a node is nothing but a server or center software. If you don't have a node, that means if you don't have a particular part of the software, laptop or PC or server, if you don't have that one, yes, you can't install any Informatica software. So that's why we are primarily calling it as a node, and without node you can't install Informatica Power Center. Okay, and a domain is nothing but a collection of repository services which is having more than one node also. That means you can join the same domain with two nodes. That is nothing but to manage the load balancing. So basically what it's saying, see, this is a domain, okay, and it is a collection of node and different services. If you have two nodes, yes, you can join the same nodes into the same domain same domain. That means join the domain. While installing itself, Informatica will ask you about whether it's joining the domain or joining existing domain or creating a new domain. First time, you can install smoothly, saying that there is a new creation of new domain. Yeah, I got a ping. Okay, so a node, I mean, that means first time you can install a node in Informatica PowerCenter software in one node. It asks that whether we need to create new domain or existing domain. Once you install, okay. So once you install that one, next time you would like to install in the same, I mean, Informatica software in another computer, another PC. Okay, at that time, if you use the existing domain, that means the same. This domain can be joined with the two nodes. Why two nodes? Because previously we don't have a type of grid concept. Okay, and grid is nothing but joining two domains. I mean, joining one domain with the two different nodes. There is a complex, you know, a little bit technical terms are there. Please feel to ask me so that, you know, I can give a good solution. What is a node and what is a domain? Just a little bit complex technical terms are there. Okay, don't hesitate to ask me. Okay, and again, so if you join the domain with the same two nodes, we can use, I mean, if any node is down, unfortunately, some database issue or some network issue, something somewhere it is down, whatever the services, Informatica service, integration service, okay, whatever the services are there, it will automatically up in the backup domain. That is node 2. Okay, that's another picture. That means we have a node 1 is a primary and node 2 would be backup. Once node 1 is down, unfortunately, then node 2 will be taking care about in the repos services and whatever the service there in the particular node. Once you maintain that these services should run on node backup node once node 1 is down. This is a little bit complexity is there. Okay, if you have any questions, please ping me. I'll unmute you so that we can talk. So this is all part of domain as well as domain and a node. Repos service, a service which is maintaining all communication with the designer tools. Okay, that means whatever you create here, repos service, this is nothing but a repos service. Okay, which is whatever the name it has, the same name which should present in the client tools. I'll tell you the client tools, what we have client tools. This is all about Informatica admin console, how Informatica is working and what are the different types of services which we have. Okay, it's a Informatica repository service. Okay, then it's a service which maintains what are the tasks you are doing. Okay, and Informatica client tools. Okay, then again, coming to integration service. Without integration service, you can't execute the sessions or workflows. I'll tell you later. Once we start Informatica development activities, I'll show you. And basically, this is the integration service. So we have different types of integration service, and ASCII is a default thing which moves the data from source to target with ASCII mode. And Unicode is a thing which if your source system is having Japanese characters, okay, or a Chinese characters or some dollar symbols, and ASCII could not transform the source to target. It gives some question mark symbols. For that, Informatica design data movement would be Unicode. That means it converts the data, particular data characters into Unicode level. Then again, it transforms into the target, which is having a Unicode data, which will show you the exact symbol what is the source system contains. That is nothing but, see, you can see it's a data mode is ASCII, and if I click here Unicode, it shows data movement is Unicode. So that means if you have a source system is having a Chinese or Japanese characters, and if you use this type of this integration service, and if you run the job what you have, it will give you exact source data into the respective target without any changes. I mean, without any changes means the characters what you in the source system, it will be present in the target. Okay, for that we need to use for Unicode integration service. These are the two integration service which we can create at admin console level. And then again, if you don't have a repository service, you can't create these two integration service. Integration services are dependent on repository service. How to create a repository service? Actions means, see, if you don't click on mine and click action new, the different types of services which we can create. Okay, and repos set up tables which have a you do in the designer or workflow level or session level, whatever you're doing there, it will present in the backend repository tables. Oracle we can use by default, but Teradata or any database should be required to create a domain as well as to install your Informatica software. That is the primary thing. Oracle or any database, SQL Server or Teradata, okay, or RDBMS, any database should be required to install Informatica PowerCenter. Without that, repository cannot be, it never installs, and however, moreover, repository tables cannot be created. So for end of the day, we need a database to install this particular Informatica software. I'll give you the exact notes how to install Informatica 9 software, okay, in your Windows and in your PC. So why, what is the backend process going on? So this is the, basically database. Once you see the database, it contains backend. We have so many tables which will store exact data what you are doing in the tool level, GUI, graphic user interface. It stores in the database level, that is repository database. We have installation for Informatica, we have domain objects and client objects. Domain objects are nothing but integration service, a repository service, a repository service process and node, which I have already showed you. This is the one. Domain, node, and repository service, and integration service. So these are the main things which we need to, which we need for installation in Informatica. Okay, and coming to client objects, we have a designer, repository manager, workflow manager, workflow monitor. There are four client objects which we can work different types of implementation. Designer will show you, will give you the mappings perspective, and repository manager will give you how to create folders and how to manage the access. Okay, and workflow manager which will give you how to load, what type of tables in the report, designer. What is the mapping you have, which will take care about manager and monitor. Once you start the job, the monitor will show you what type of job. I'll show you one by one. Once we start, okay. Once we start client objects and demo domain objects, I'll show you how to do the mapping, how to create a folder, okay, and how to do the access permissions. These are different objects. How to do the ETL, simple mappings and basic mapping and complex mappings. And basically, this is client tools overview used to create folders. I mean, repository manager used for folder creation and security purpose, and manage permissions. Designer for the sources and targets, how to connect to the source system and how to extract the exact sources, and what would be the target and where we need to create for target. Okay, what type of database it requires. Okay, and mapping, maplets, and transformations. Transformation is nothing but a business logic which you can implement exact business logic, what user is looking for, and what type of logic can be implemented at transformation level, I mean mapping level, by using the different types of transformations. We have around 17 transformations are available, and I'll give you each and every transformation example. Okay, and I'll give you the task for the exact transformation so that you can work at your practice level. If you have any question that the particular transformation, then just please let me know so that I'll give you the exact solution for that, so that you can work again. The task that once you start working on that, you'll get a good idea. And if you have any doubts, yes, I'll show the way how to get the solution done. Okay, that is the practice part. If you don't do the practice, I mean, no need to worry about. I mean, just learning is not important. But whatever the task I'm giving, just please work on it. Then only you can get in a good command. What type of transformations is required for particular business logics. Okay, and I have different types of examples. Okay, and I'll show you each and every transformation with examples, and I'll create a mapping here in my desktop. I'll give you a task, and if you could not do that, just I'll send the XML so that you can just test it in your desktop. So at least you will get a good idea, and make sure that you are practicing what type of task which I am giving. That is the one thing which I am expecting from you guys, so that you will get a good command instead of learning and just forgetting. If you do the work, lab practice, yes, you will get a good command. Okay, and a repository manager which gives you folder creation and security. A workflow manager which designs the sessions, workflows, a database connection, server, and what type of workloads which we need to, what type of jobs we require to execute the particular workflows. A monitor is a thing which, what are the process, what are the job is executing, it will show you the particular part. Okay, whether this time it's executing, and so and so records are reading, and so and so records are loading. What are the failures that are happening? You can get the session logs from the workflow monitor. Okay, so this is the demo class. So I'm just stopping here, and we'll start exact class from. I mean, once you confirm that, Kapil will send you the invitation again. Okay, so that we'll start. Exact class, and how I'll show you how to install Informatica and where we can get Informatica. I'll give you briefly one by one. Okay, I'm just unmuting you all guys, and please feel to you can speak now.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah.
I can hear you.
What are the timings you're going to have the classes?